Probabil credeai că o operație pe inimă înseamnă piept deschis, tăieturi mari și luni întregi de recuperare? Dar ce ai zice dacă ți-aș spune că se poate și fără să se taie sternul, chiar și cu inima bătând? În spitalele Acibadem, chirurgia cardiovasculară a intrat în era high-tech și ei sunt printre primii care au adoptat chirurgia robotică. Am discutat despre toate astea cu doctorul Shahin Şenay, unul dintre cei mai apreciați chirurgi cardiovasculari ai Turciei, cu o experiență de peste 14 ani în intervenții complexe, inclusiv cazuri ce au fost refuzate în alte centre. A operat peste 800 de pacienți folosind tehnici minim invazive, intervenind pe valvele inimii, arterele coronare sau chiar pe aortă, fără să deschidă sternul, folosind un sistem robotic de ultimă generație.
Usually the access is for the bypass surgery is from the left side and around four small holes in the left chest. For the valve operations like the mitral and the tricuspid operations and even for the aortic operations, we use the right side. There can be even again the four small holes in the right side. So if you do not cut the bone here,
there are situations where you need to cut the
bone. We still do this operation, but in case that we can achieve the same operation without cutting this, we would go for doing that kind of
and
operation.
And of course, the recovery is much faster. How many days? Usually, the patient to stay
usually in a robotic assisted bypass surgery, for example, it is usually around 4.5 hours in the operation room and one night in the surgical ICU, intensive care units, and then usually 4 or 5 days in the hospital.
Okay, so, very fast.
Yeah, and then we discharge the patient, then this patient usually comes for a control after 1 week or 10 days. And after that control, usually the normal life is more or less achievable. I mean, regular days are usually achievable.
Do you do exercise testing? Medical cardiology deals with that?
Yeah, we have a fast track protocol here in means of recovery, and we try to make the patient walk as soon as possible in the possibly first day.
It starts
with this kind of exercise and also some kind of additional physiotherapy activities.
You say that after a bypass, robotic bypass, they walk in the first day? Yes?
Post-operative first day,
This is...
so we gradually increase the exercise strength.
Yes.
And in the fourth day, usually walking is, I mean, in the hospital is usually... achievable in a long distance.
Yes.
So in the home, it's again repeated by the patient and his or her relatives. And when he comes back for control, we do some kind of tests. And after that, usually daily life is achievable.
Domnul doctor mi-a explicat că practic se fac câteva puncții. Se umflă toracele cu aer și se lucrează pe interior fără incizie. Iar durerea postoperatorie este foarte mică. În unele cazuri de bypass coronarian, când sunt doar unul sau două vase blocate, intervenția se poate efectua chiar și cu inima bătând, fără a fi nevoie de circulație extracorporeală. În aceste situații, procedura devine extrem de sigură, cu sângerare minimă, risc redus de infecții sau alte complicații și are o recuperare mult mai rapidă. Acesta este un avantaj major, mai ales pentru pacienții diabetici, la care se știe că recuperarea este în general mai dificilă. Majoritatea pacienților stau doar o noapte la terapie, apoi pot să meargă încă din prima zi. Mai rămân în spital până la 5 zile și revin la activitatea normală foarte repede. Un lucru aproape imposibil în chirurgia clasică.
Of course you do also interventional cardiology. Stents
because
or...
at least some of the patients are not suitable for surgery.
Yes.
So it has an issue with the anesthesia, it has an issue with the incisions. So in that group of patients we try to select the interventional option in means of safety of the operation and also benefit for the long term. So in that case, we have some kind of angiographic solution for different scenarios, different diseases.
Maybe they have only one artery. You choose interventional better, but if they have two or three arteries, you choose bypass.
Even in two or three vessels, we can again go for interventional solution.
Okay.
But the main point is to decide which therapy is much more beneficial in the long term.
Okay.
So, for example, just think about a young patient with an age of around 50 or something like that. This is something that we see this kind of patients more and more in the current days. So in this, for this kind of a patient, the long term is very, very important. So, for example, for this kind of a patient, we do not go for a stenting or interventional therapy. We try to go for robot-assisted bypass with an arterial graft, which is much more durable.
You use arterial graft, mammary arteria or not?
So there are options for the arterial grafts. The mammary artery on the left side, the mammary artery on the right side, and also the radial artery.
Okay.
So usually these are enough for full arterial revascularization in coronary bypass surgeries.
Alegerea terapiei potrivite este bine să se facă în funcție și de interesul pe termen lung al pacientului. Și mai ales în cazul celor tineri, este de preferat bypassul coronarian minim invaziv în locul stentării. Cei interesați pot solicita chiar și o consultație online de la distanță pentru a obține o a doua opinie și a vedea care intervenții sunt mai potrivite în cazul lor. Domnul doctor mi-a mai precizat și faptul că, având o experiență vastă, ei organizează traininguri pentru medici din alte țări, precum Germania sau Marea Britanie.
What's your experience in robotic surgery? How many years or how many cases?
So it has been now 14 years, so this is the first hospital in Turkey and one of the first hospitals in Europe that deals with robotic cardiac surgery. And currently, we run a program of robotic coronary bypass surgery and robotic valve surgery together. And also, we try to provide some kind of a training and some kind of supervising for other hospitals, for example, in Germany or UK. So we try to assist them for starting this kind of operation.
People from Germany or UK come here to
Last month, there was a team from UK. The plan is they will start a new program, robotic coronary bypass surgery, and they are trying to adapt the know-how that they have seen here.
Yes.
They are preparing the infrastructure issues now, and hopefully before the end of this year they will start the program. The main point is that when you share the knowledge, it expands, and this is kind of something beneficial for the patients.
Dacă vrei să fii contactat de un consultant, scrie Aci Badem în comentarii.